Do you know which river is the longest in Europe? If you want to find out the name of it, stay till the end of this video of 5 longest rivers in Europe. Number 5. River Don. The 5th longest river in Europe, the Don. It is flowing from the central Russia to the southern Russia. 60 kilometers southeast of Tula is the town named Novomoskovsk where the Don raises. With its length of 1870 kilometers, it flows right into the Sea of Azov. City Rostov-on-Don is located by the Sea of Azov, where the River Don also flows out, and it is the main city on the River Don. According to the Kurgan hypothesis, around 4000 BC, the Volga-Don River region was the homeland of the Proto-Indo-Europeans. The nomadic pastoralism of the Proto-Indo-Europeans was a result of fusing with the hunter-gatherer culture of Siberian groups and Neolithic farmer culture from the Near East. River Don was very important for Byzantine Empire because of its trading route for traders from Byzantium. By some ancient Greek geographers, River Don was viewed as border between Europe and Asia. The river was also a home to the legendary Amazons of Greek mythology, and it has been speculated to be the source of the Black Death in the mid-14th century. The entire route of the river and all its outflows were finally drawn in 1661 by Baron Augustin von Meyerberg. The Don River merges with the Volga River into a 101 km long Volga-Don Canal, which allows vessels up to the size of tankers to reach the Caspian and the Baltic Sea. A river's minimum discharge is 42 cubic meters and its maximum is 11,185 cubic meters per second. In 1964, River also appeared in the Hungarian drama film named The Sons of the Stone-Hearted Man. Number 2. River Dnieper. On number 4 comes River Dnieper, also known as Dnipro. It is rising in the Valdai Hills, and before flowing out into the Black Sea, it goes through the Belarus and Ukraine, where it is also the longest. Throughout the history, the Dnieper has bisected Ukraine to the right and left banks. Today it is known for its mighty hydroelectric power stations and dams. It's one of the most important navigable waterways for the economy of Ukraine. Dnieper was also known to the Boreasteans and ancient Greeks and was part of the Amber Road. Dnieper's river drainage basin covers 504,000 square kilometers and has around 32,000 tributaries, of which 89 being over 100 plus kilometer long rivers. Its average discharge is 1,670 cubic meters per second. Before 1932, when the Dnieper hydroelectric station was built, there were 9 major rapids obstructing full width of the river, about 60 islands and 30 to 40 smaller rapids. In one part of the river you can find quagga mussel, which has been brought to it accidentally and now it is invasive species. Nowadays it is important for the economy and transport of Ukraine. It is used for the transport of tourists as well as cargo ships. Dnieper is also connected with the Western European waterways, but because of the poor political relationships between Belarus and Europe, waterways are closed. To show us your support, click like and subscribe button. Number 3. River Ural. Until 1775, it was called River Yaik. It originates in the southern Ural Mountains and it's flowing 2,428 kilometers through Russia and Kazan as a continent border between Asia and Europe into the Caspian Sea. When it flows to the West Kazan region and Atyrau region of Kazan Ural, it splits them into two distributaries named Yaik and Zoltoy. The Yaik distributary is with almost no trees on the shores, very shallow but rich in fish, while as Zoltoy is much deeper and more navigable. Upon reaching the Caspian Sea, the Ural form a digitate or more known as tree-like delta on the plain. The river is mostly fed by melting snow, which causes spring floods in April and March. During spring floods, the river widens to above 10 kilometers near the city Uralsk, and at the mouth it widens to several tens of kilometers. The average depth of the river is 1 to 1.5 meters, but in the time of spring floods, the level of water rises up to 10 meters. River's minimum discharge is 1.62 cubic meters per second, and its maximum is 14,000 cubic meters per second. There are a few reservoirs and a hydroelectric power plant on the river. Low reaches are used for irrigation. Due to the rich fish delta of Ural, it represents as much as half of all fish caught in Kazakhstan. There is an estimated 5 to 10,000 species, but most of them are insects. From 10th to 16th century, there was a city on the Ural River named Sarai Yik, which was an important trading center on the Silk Road. Then, in late 16th century, the Ural Basin was conquested by Russians, and Ural shores became home to the Yaik Cossacks. Yaik's main activity was fishing, and there were a lot of fishing techniques. The most famous was the technique called bagrene, and it was allowed only on one day of the year. Because of the largest rebellion in Russia, on 15th of January 1775, the Empress Catherine issued a decree. The decree was to rename the places involved in the revolt. So the Yaik River was renamed to the Ural River, and the Yaik Cossacks were renamed to the Ural Cossacks. Number 2. River Danube. Flowing through 10 countries, Danube was once used by Roman Empire for frontier. It spans through Central and Eastern Europe, originating in Germany, more precisely in the Black Forest town Donaueschingen. From the Black Forest, Danube flows 2,850 kilometers southeast, passing Bavaria, Austria, Slovakia, Hungary, Croatia, Romania, Bulgaria, Moldova, and Ukraine. It has few dams and an iron gate, where it reaches a discharge of 6,500 cubic meters per second. Then it flows free for 860 kilometers to the Black Sea, where it flows out. To the Proto-Indo-Europeans, Danube was known as Danal, and to the ancient Greeks it was known as Istros. In 1994, the Danube was declared one of 10 pan-European transport corridors. It is navigable by ocean ships from the Black Sea to Bralia in Romania, and then by river ships to Kelheim, Germany. Between 1987 and 1999, about 100 million tons of goods were transported on the Danube. Piracy was also a huge problem on the river between Serbia and Romania, until the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea defined it as river robbery, meaning that crews on transport ships steal and sell their own goods. Danube's basin was the site of some of the earliest human cultures, and besides using it just as a border on the Danube River, some of the most important wars of the Ottoman Empire had happened. Danube is also a source of drinking water in some areas along its course. In the Middle Ages, fishing was also a very important activity, but it has declined dramatically. There is a lot of tourist spots along the Danube, and over 17 cruise liners are in use on the river, and you can also go along it by bike, train, or walk. And the last one, River Volga. The longest river in Europe, with the length of 3,531 kilometers, and in terms of discharge and drainage basin, the largest river in Europe is Volga. The Volga drainage basin covers 9 of 10 largest cities of Russia, including the capital Moscow. The river has a symbolic meaning for the Russians, as it marks their culture, which is why in various literature and Russian folklore we perceive it as the Volga Matushka or the Mother Volga. The river got its name from Proto-Slavic term Volga, which means moisture, wetness. At an altitude of 225 meters in the Valdai Hills, the Volga makes its way east past Lake Sterts and Kazan, then turns onto the south and continues its journey towards Volgograd, which was considered Stalingrad during the Soviet era. With around 500 channels and smaller rivers, Volga's delta measures about 160 kilometers. Volga's average discharge is around 8,100 cubic meters. Its minimum is 3,918 cubic meters and its maximum is an astonishing 24,022 cubic meters per second. It has many tributaries, and in the winter months, Volga freezes along its entire length due to the low temperatures, which are normal for Russia. And due to the large hydropower stations, irrigation systems, and transport canals, the river has been severely affected by the chemical pollution. Canals like Volga-Don Canal, Volga-Baltic Canal, and Moscow Canal waterways are connecting the central Russia with the White Sea, Baltic Sea, Caspian Sea, Black Sea, and Sea of Azov. The Volga Delta is an oil hub, and natural gas also occurs in some places. It is also known for fishing in the Volga Delta all the way to the Caspian Sea. During the huge Stalin's industrialization, Volga was important for transport and inland shipping in Russia. Now dams on the river have been equipped with large ship locks so that vessels of pretty large dimensions can travel from the Caspian Sea almost to the upstream end of the river. In Soviet era, grain and oil have been among the largest cargo exports transported on the Volga, until Russia didn't close waterways to access into its inland. And that was all for today's video of 5 longest rivers in Europe. Hope you enjoyed, and we see you in the next one.